June 15th.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I got two more coming in. Two folders.
Good evening. We'd like to get our induction ceremony ready to go. And at this time, we would like to welcome you. And we will give you a little bit of the history of National Honor Society here at Merrill High School. And then the NHS officers will be reading some specifics about the principles of NHS. Students are admitted in the fall and in the spring, but the induction doesn't take place until nearly the end of the year. These students participate in a number of different activities besides NHS, as well as helping around the school. For instance, the Wisconsin Educational Fair, which will be held in our field house, our students will be helping guide people around, handing out items to people, etc. So at this time, I would like to introduce Chad Sharon, President of National Honor Society.
Membership of the Viola M. Hull National Honor Society has a long tradition of history. The National Honor Society is the oldest national organization in the United States that recognizes and advocates scholarship, service, leadership, and character. In 1919, Edward Reinerson and J.G. Masters came up with the idea of creating an organization to distinguish students for possessing these qualities. They proposed the idea at their annual convention of the National Association of Secondary School Principals in 1921. At the convention, a resolution was passed to form NHS, and Edward Reinerson's Fifth Avenue High School in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, was awarded Charter Number 1 in the National Honor Society. Today, there are more than 20,000 chapters chartered, and membership in the NHS has become recognized nationally as one of the highest honors that can be bestowed upon a high school student. Our local chapter is named after Miss Viola M. Holt, who was an American Problems teacher at Merrill High School for 16 years. Merrill's National Honor Society was started after the retirement of Miss Holt and was named in her honor because of the NHS characteristics that she displayed so well during her teaching career. Miss Holt was the chairperson of the senior class advisors and the social science department. She was an active member of the community through her membership in the Wesleyan Guild, the Business and Professional Women's Club of Merrill, the Order Eastern Star, the Wisconsin Alumni Group, the National Education Association, and the National Council of Social Sciences. Miss Holt passed away on April 12, 1962, after a long illness. Although the exact year of Merrill National Honor Society's activation is unknown, it is known that in 1974, Merrill's chapter was dedicated. However, was deactivated. However, after a six-year dormancy, the National Honor Society was reactivated and has been going strong ever since. We hope that NHS at Merrill will continue to provide recognition and an opportunity for many classes to come. The membership of the Viola M. Holt chapter of the National Honor Society has been earned by the effective demonstration of the four qualities held in high esteem by the society. Four of our members will review these qualities for the candidates. First will be scholarship, by our treasurer, Tony Haas.
Scholarship. Scholarship means a commitment to learning. A student is willing to spend hours in reading and study, knowing the lasting benefits of a cultivated mind. We should continue to learn even when formal education has ended, for our education ends only with life. Knowledge is one great element in life which leads to the highest success, and it can be acquired in only one way, through diligence and effort. Learning furnishes the lamp by which we read the past and the light which illuminates the future. Candidates have the charge to continually expand their world through the opportunities inherent in scholarship.
And next will be our historian, Ellie Rhodes.
service. Service can be described in various ways. In a routine of the day's work, many opportunities arrive to help others. Willingness to work for the benefit of those in need, without monetary compensation or without recognition, is the quality we seek in our membership. We are committed to the idea of volunteering our time and abilities to the creation of a better tomorrow.
And next is leadership from our secretary, Jenny Zellner. Character is the force within each individual which distinguishes that person from others. It gives each one individuality. It is that without which no one can respect oneself, nor hope to attain the respect of others. It is this force of character which guides one through life and, when once developed, grows steadily. Character is achieved and not received. It is the product of constant action, daily striving to make the right choice. The problem of character is the problem of self-control. We must be in reality what we wish to appear to others. By demonstrating such qualities as reliability, honesty, and sincerity, we may hope to prove by example that we value character.
At this time, we'll do the actual induction of new members. When I call your name, we will ask you to come up to the stage, going that way, to pick up your certificate and your membership card, and to sign your name into the membership book, and then to remain on stage until we have all of the new members with us and we can do the induction pledge. Angela Young. Amy Wendorf. Donna Vorpagel. Catherine Van Straten. Benjamin Szymanski. Carrie Strand. Sarah Smith, Jennifer Smith, Ryan Sabatke, Callie Reinhardt, Lee Pufall, Krista Peterson, Nathan Oland, Janelle Oland, Jenna Newman, Megan Mueller, Christina Muller, Daniel Moore, Jackie Moreland, Catherine Meyer, Skylar Lynn, Joshua Kufal. Derek Krause. David Conkle. Lydia Callio. Rachel Iatoni. Fawn Hudgens. Craig Henson. Michael Hanhart. Paula Gridley. Derek Grenfell. Molly Greenwood. Stephanie Erdman. Ryan Dukes. Jamie Borkert. Mitch Zimke. Brandy Weber. Kellen Williams. Mark Sanders. Erica Schlieff. Jill Rajek. Timothy Peterson. Elizabeth Mann. Blake Johnson. Amanda Cipra. Jenny Burnt. Zach Andreski. All of the students that you see behind me have attained a high GPA. They have filled out a very extensive application, including an essay. And then their essay and recommendations by teachers were presented to the faculty committee, and they made the choices as to which students would be admitted for this year. Those students who are seniors will also receive honors cords that they will wear at graduation, and those will be awarded during scholarship night later in the spring. Our final activity will be a field trip to Milwaukee. We'll visit the Milwaukee Public Museum, the Milwaukee County Zoo, and a shopping center. Then we'll arrive home. So all new members, of course, are welcome to sign up for that field trip. It will be May 10th, and we're leaving at 5 or so in the morning, and we should be back by 10 that evening, and the sign-up sheet is on my classroom door. I want to tell all the parents who are here, as well as the students, that Ms. Feldner and I are extremely happy that you are here and are part of our organization. At this time, Chad will read the induction pledge.
Okay, after each line, could you repeat after me? I pledge myself to uphold the high purposes of the National Honor Society, to which I have been selected. I will be true to the principles for which it stands. I will be loyal to my school and will maintain and encourage high standards of scholarship, service, leadership, and character.
They really are smart kids. Let's give them a hand. And now we would like you to join us in the commons area for just a small reception. And our officers will lead you that way in case you're not familiar how to get from here to there.